tucked way Lee winter magazine, double XL. Lost with your Gucci on. Somebody getting this motherfucking work. I'm broadcasting this bitch. We only motherfucking hot. Come watch the game and find out. My glass is dirty. It's the clean these niggas. Man. Is that Quan bitch, eh? Boy, that sound like your whole way. Oh, I said your whole ass up. Yeah, we know what JB sound like. We know what JB sound like. We know what your ugly ass sound like. Short.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. The Vikings come into today's matchup wanting to find a way to walk out of the stadium with win number 5 on the season. It's the Saints going up against the Vikings.
EA Sports coverage takes us to one of the newest jewels on the NFL landscape, U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Between the New Orleans Saints and the Minnesota Vikings. First carry now for Dalvin Cook. Nowhere to go that time. Mike.
Oh, here you go with the pause and shit.
Second down throw for Bridgewater. And a quick throw here. That's complete. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs.
And let's face it, that what we just saw there, not a surprise, is it? I mean, this is what he does well. And if you don't tackle him as soon as he catches the ball, this is the end result. Big yardage after it.
Got the speed, the agility, so good with that after catching. Only in the first quarter, so they better get a wrangle and a hold on that quickly.
Yeah, you're exactly right. And what's really difficult to try and defend him is if you want to press him so that you get him on the ground quickly after the catch, a lot of times he'll just run past you at the initial point of contact, and he'll go deep.
He's going to loft one deep left side here. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Second down throw for Bridgewater. Room to run inside the 40. And he's brought down. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. And the offense lining up first and 10. To the air again with Bridgewater. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And a big hit at the end of that one.
Come watch the stream and find out.
He's knocked down hard. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Come watch the stream and find out, man.
And again, it's Bridgewater. And no
escaping. Give me that sack, bitch.
He'll go down. They got him for a sack. Alex Anzalone in there to drop him for his 5th sack of the year. Third and long now after the sack, and we'll see if Bridgewater has a response. Out of the gun, Bridgewater.
Oh shit, let me go. Almost got my head. Another outlet.
It's a great job by this secondary. When I watch them, they remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on third down to bring
up. Oh, that nigga missed a field goal.
Hits the crossbar and comes back, and it's no good.
Somebody wants to be
just a whisker. This remains a scoreless game. Now they're set up nicely at the 45-yard line after the missed field goal from 55. Now a first carry for T.J. Yeldon. And a second.
Thing, but they can't just throw it on every single down without expecting some real heat from the pass rush.
He wet, bro. Come downstairs.
They're running again with you. And he'll take it down shy to 45 in the
36th. Chase. Another fucking party, bro. I'm not some dude tuning that damn rapper shit, bro.
It's now third and very short in order to try and pick up a first down.
Back-to-back 11-yard gains, and they've got another first down.
Do you want to leave me because you rapping?
First down carry now for Yeldon. And some room to work. And he'll get down to about the 26-yard line. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one. Big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
A first carry now.
Give me down.
Alvin Kamara, and he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line.
First down, bitch.
Only a gain of a yard. Ball and go whole way. All they needed is that's going to move the chains.
He was even that damn field goal.
Staying on the ground on first, Kamara.
Alvin Kamara.
Tackle, but really able to work this down near the 23.
Pussy.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
I should have put Kevin Bacon.
There wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it. Because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Throwing now is Carr. Steps away to his left.
Let's face it, you can run the route.
Come on, baby.
As many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get the game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
And he can't hang on to it. Nearly picked. He's known for his hands defensively. But instead, it just brings up fourth down. And Lutz's kick is good. And the Saints are going to take a 3-0 lead. So the scoring drive encompasses 9 plays, but the net gain, 3 points.
And you're going to have drives like that in this league. Sometimes you just got to take the 3 and move on. Always better than nothing.
This is taken about 7 yards deep. And now out comes Minnesota. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
You better throw that shit away, fuck
nigga. Rid of it, throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. On second down, Bridgewater again. Eluding the pressure right. Now he's going to send this one deep right. And got his man complete.
Oh, get the fuck out of here.
Taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40.
Get some bullshit.
Very nice pickup of 33 yards.
Dagger. First down, here's the run with Cook.
Oh my God, Dalvin Cook is not that fucking good.
First down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
They run again on first down. Cook. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain.
I know exactly what he's going to do.
Give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
It's really simple to say that they know their identity, that they are a passing team. But one of the reasons that they're so successful, they know how to mix in the run and make sure that they keep the defense off balance and not able to just simply say, let's go get the quarterback and disrupt things.
This motherfucking got the fuck. Oh, my God. They signed Aaron Rodgers for no fucking reason.
Obviously a big play was needed, and you can see his eyes already back up.
So this nigga took Aaron Rodgers out just to
take off and goes a long way. Not only does he pick up a first down, but a big gain to boot.
Oh my God, I can't put a fucking
from the red zone now. Bridgewater.
Get him
down to McKinnon. And he's gonna be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. Give him 9 on the play, and that'll make it second and short.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
Dance hammering for the goal line.
Fumble, bitch.
The football. And this is fumble, bitch. The Saints. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
When I see a play like that, I come back to risk reward. I don't know about you, but is it worth it at that point, whatever you're going to pick up, to either take the hit, and in this case, lose the football?
So you're
blocked.
I mean, hindsight's always 20-20, but that's the safe play.
He's out there.
Whoa. Come on.
Because you can analyze it, but I think ultimately you got to look at it as a first option, taking care of the ball, getting what you can, and that's it. Don't worry about it anymore.
They'll try a little trickery here on the end around.
He's trying to look at
the strip. He's here at the 28. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
That run right there was an offensive line coach's dream, wasn't it? Guys picked up all their assignments, created a nice gap for the running back to get through.
So the first quarter, he's getting frustrated.
Yeah, he's probably chortling on the headset right now.
He's going for strip.
We got it going, boys. Let's keep it going.
On 2nd down, here's Yeldon. And some space here.
You can't stop TJ Yeldon that season. Because I was, hey, that down that lead the way.
Call it a gain of 7 and it gets him a new set of downs. Getting the sense Charles are going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
Keep it with Yeldon. First down. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. It's a loss of 5 there, bringing up 2nd.
Every year I go to the combine to marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs. And let's face it, they know how to finish plays, too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
Now they'll throw with Carr. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a 3rd down.
Oh, shoot. I'm going out here, yeah.
Carr going to try and throw on 3rd down. Trying to get it to Thomas, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Anthony Barr.
I should not have thrown that down. Why Anthony Barr so damn tall?
Short throw, pick 6 right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide.
Damn, I should not have thrown that damn pass.
Anticipation on the play, reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
So they throw the pick 6 to get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
What are you doing?
This is fielded a couple yards deep.
And he's able to get it across
the
20,
but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Out onto the field comes New Orleans.
I didn't lose.
And you know, certainly a lot of football left to be played. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're first place in their division, looking good, looking to be a threat come January.
And let's think about what every team has in their goals, all right? Number one goal is what? Make the playoffs. Number two goal is win your division. Number three goal, and the biggest goal, I think, is to be the highest seed possible that you can be heading into the playoffs so that you can have as many home games as possible to try to get you to the Super Bowl.
And right now, fighting for every win possible to try to at least secure home field for the wild card and the divisional round.
I don't know what this is. Nigga, no. Fuck him. You not even that shit.
Man, on second down, here's
Carr. Oh, these niggas, this shit didn't work that perfect.
Being chased out left.
God damn, throw the ball!
Drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
It's not like pressure to affect the accuracy and the timing of a guy.
God damn!
Ball. And on that play, they ended up flushing him to his left. Contacted him as he's trying to throw the football, and that led to the incompletion.
Throw left side.
Good job.
It's Alexander. The pickup of 11, and it moves the chains. They'll run it now out of the gun.
Power, oh, bitch.
Oh, he's got a little daylight.
Oh, man, chuck this nigga, Mike.
Over the 40 to the 42. Just when you went on a first down run, call it 8 yards, and it's second and two. Now Carr throwing on second down. Oh, he's got a man wide open.
I'm fucking this dig up.
Goes for 24
we'll get your bitch ass. I come for it. Come for 3 hard flaps. Pussy. Pussy.
First down. To the right side, and he's got more complete. Give him a couple on the catch at second and 8.
Looked like the screen pass was taken away there, and that was a nice job of improvising, but it's not normal. Usually when the screen pass is taken away, you're trying to just throw the ball at the ground at the feet of the receiver so that you don't get it intercepted and just start over. But he ended up finding another receiver.
Running with Kamara.
Damn.
And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about 4 more for a first. Carr. Oh, look at Thomas wide
good
open.
Job. Good.
And he goes out of bounds inside the 10 at the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
This bitch ass.
They'll try and run for it with Yeldon.
Oh my God, this motherfucker! Why do y'all just run?
It's a loss of two.
Y'all run, we are good and golden.
So the myth has been shattered. Every cornerback in the league is not just a cover corner. Some of them will stick their nose in there and make plays, exactly as we just saw there. A big loss suffered by the offense after that nice tackle.
And he will go down. Outside of the pocket for a sack. Tried to get away, but could not. Danielle Hunter in there to get him, and that's sack number 8 for him on the year. Under 4 to play now. Clock running. Third down. Forced out to his left. He can run for it, and he will. And, oh, he is really laid out that time. Knocked flat on his back at the 11-yard line.
Well, partner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to escape out of there, and he doesn't pick up a first down, but he does gain additional yardage to set up a possible field goal attempt if they decide to go that route.
And, Charles, they get the field goal. Took him a dozen plays, though.
Work with me on this one. You know what I'm about to say, right? Bend but don't break. That's what came into play here for the defense. 12 plays were run at them. They only gave up 3 points. In a lot of ways, that's a win for the defense.
This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. And the Vikings now heading on to the field. And they'll be looking to atone for last time's mistake of fumbling inside the red zone. Certainly they don't want to do that again.
And so much emphasis placed on red zone offense. I mean, you have periods devoted in practice
for that,
because everyone knows how vital it is to put points on the board when you've entered that part of the field. And to come away with nothing, that's difficult for a team to handle.
And difficult, and now we'll see if they can make it less difficult on themselves on this drive.
This nigga not a fucking dude. That's all this nigga not a fucking dude. Them damn bullshit ass shit, man. That's all this nigga not a fucking dude. That's some bullshit.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
He's going to flip one out here to his running back. He'll get nothing out of that one, and it's going to lead to a third down.
Brandon, just mark that under the category of just not successful. Trying to throw the ball, just out didn't route. Work on that one.
Out route. Completed it. Out route.
No yardage. On third and one, here's Bridgewater. And he couldn't
drop
hang
that.
On to it
through he dropped
contact.
That.
Incomplete.
Perhaps they overthought this one a little bit. They've been running it real well on this drive, and it was third and short, okay? They decided to throw the football. Incomplete. Yeah, they might have thought just a little bit too hard about that play selection.
The Vikings send out their punter, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. Fair catch called for and collected right at the 10-yard line. No return, but it goes down as just a punt of 31 yards. And the Saints will take over with a first and 10 deep in their own territory. They'll start out on the ground. It's TJ Yeldon.
Damn,
and he's going to be taken down here at about the 10. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. And an alley to run. And he slides to avoid the hit. Carr can beat you in a lot of ways. The scramble there, a perfect example as he gets the first.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
They'll try the right side here with Yeldon. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. More from Minneapolis.
I didn't even hit that nigga with the play. I'm bullshitting. Oh. I didn't hit that play. That motherfucking clip.
Again, it's Yeldon.
Oh, this nigga tripped. What the fuck
are they doing there? He'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. 2 yards gets him back to where they started, but now...
Damn, this nigga tripped with a damn D-tackle.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, four plays in this drive, all four on the ground. Throwing his car on third down. He'll have a first down past the 40.
Come on, good job.
If
he's gonna stay cover three, Scott, I'm gonna hold you keeping it up. You damn power. Well, he can't stop these shits.
The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Now a handoff to Yeldon, and he'll be tackled right on the midfield logo. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. Carr signaling to his guys, let's go here. Now it's Yeldon running right. 12 yards there as they move the chains. First down now, but the clock continues to move.
Boy, does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
Let's touchdown!
It's a touchdown! And we'll have to check the
decline
flag.
That bitch. Touchdown, foot me.
And yes, they want the points, so they will decline the penalty. No question there.
You don't think they spent a couple seconds mulling over with the penalty?
You can keep Brandon Grant. Maurice Alexander, I got some fantastic. It's the motherfucking goat.
Take the points and keep moving.
wants now to kick this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
She's not talking to that motherfucker. Check.
And now out comes Minnesota. And hoping to do better than they did their last possession.
You see, he's not talking to that motherfucker. Check.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the
look
line
at
of scrimmage.
Bitch.
If you do that,
he
can't
move ball off
first
of
down.
Fuck,
you
man.
Win second down.
Fuck, boy.
And guess what? You start accumulating first down.
Oh, shit.
And that's what they need in order to now pump the ball again.
Looking deep downfield.
Catch the pick. Down in this is a pick. Y'all
thought he
catch.
Might have had it. Instead, second down.
On my mama. On my mama.
Well, sometimes those cliches really
catch the ball
come true,
a pick.
Don't they? When it takes all 11 to play good defense. We've seen that in this ball game. I think the secondary has to be singled out, though. They are in the presence of every receiver whenever the ball is thrown.
To check.
And this one,
that's all
this
nigga
gonna
do is do a damn check, man.
Sets up a third down.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch. Especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
Garnett with the pick.
Garnett with the pick. Garnett with the pick. Suss a nigga up like this. Ooh, pussy ass nigga wanna fight me. Pussy ass nigga is a bitch. Ooh. What?
It's Carr, and he's going to be out of bounds.
That's a catch
near the 35-yard line. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that
is fucking trash
at the passer.
Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive. Here's a give to Yeldon. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. And they'll burn the timeout with 5 seconds left. A chance to try to add 3 points before heading to the locker room.
So you next. Game right off.
And Lutz puts this one through. And now it's a two-score game at 9, 16-7. So they get the three, increase their lead to close out the half.
Excellent way to end a drive, going to the locker room with a little bit of extra momentum after adding 3 to their total.
This is feeling at the goal line.
He's gonna come.
So we come upon halftime with 9 points separating these two teams. As we'll send you down to Orlando, where Larry Ridley has our EA Sports halftime report. Larry, so both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Out come the Saints now. They'll go on offense first here to begin the third quarter. They have the lead now. They'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more.
Love playing trash talker, bro.
They didn't see in the first half.
See if they do just that. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. Buying time to his left. Out of the backfield, it's T.J. Yeldon. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. Now T.J. Yeldon. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
I think there's one element that just keeps increasing on defense in the NFL, and that's speed. They want it at every position, and we just saw there some linebackers who can go sideline to sideline, run past that trash, go past people, and make tackles near the sidelines.
Not only near the sideline, but also in the backfield there for the loss. It's already second and 12. The defense hoping to push him back more. Now Carr.
Ain't another one of them being.
He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field.
He overthrew. Oh my God.
Second down, couldn't connect. Now it's third.
Those throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have three points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception.
Damn, fuck, dude.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. A gain of 26 on the
third down. Derek Carr, you just pissed me off with that shit.
They were in zone.
Oh my God, you just pissed
me off.
Careful,
you're losing playing against a good quarterback like
that is bullshit.
To not play too much zone.
Yeah, you have to be careful about
bro,
how much time you're
Derek, bro,
up.
The motherfucker, so my damn receiver, Michael, son, he had to safety bump like a motherfucker. All Derek had to do, Michael Thomas, all he had to do was just make the damn play. This nigga overthrew him. In the fucking end zone.
And they're gonna go soft on the
I'm like, damn, this nigga right here.
Looking to throw on second down. Carr. That one complete to Yeldon. And he gets
this
it.
This is a real dude trying to make my ass
fall. 10 to the 5-yard line.
I ain't wondering nothing.
A really good pickup of 28 yards. And now
Derek,
first down following
come
that
on,
long
Derek.
Game.
Baby, you know I need you.
They come out here in the eye. Try to pound it in, Kamara.
Oh, come on.
Gonna feel that one.
I should have juked.
Knocked down my hard. Should've. A pickup of four on first down. Mm-hmm. It'll be second and goal.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out. But a running game can really benefit your team right now.
They'll run it with Kamara.
Small, smallest daddy wins the race. Pussy.
A great effort there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Saints now add six to their lead. Now Carr, and he's got it. So the try for two successful, and that bumps their lead up even further. Lutz now to kick this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. It's the Vikings' turn on offense. We get ready for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know in the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the
give me that pick.
Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted.
Say pick six again. Say pick. Face mask. Come on, bitch. You fucking talk shit to me like you fucking good or something, bitch. Fuck road inning. Fuck wrong with your bitch ass hoe. And I finish your ass with the damn YouTube. Fuck boy.
They'll toss it to Yeldon.
Oh, come on, man.
Fuck. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down.
But it was stopped on that play. We've had plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
This is
come on, come on, dotting that ass up.
And he's
fuck,
able
boy.
To work it here to the 8-yard line.
Pussy!
It's a gain of seven, and they're going to face a third down.
Man, dude, this is emotional game for me, bro.
Well, they were handed great starting field position on this drive, but now they face a third and four.
You figure my offense out. Bitch, I ain't
winning
this
shit. Pitch goes to Yeldon.
How you figure my offense out? I'm running shit that I wasn't I'm playing
and
run.
Now it's first and goal.
Well, someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? A lot of it's been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. They stay on the ground. This time it's
come on, Kamara.
Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown,
you want two.
You're without a doubt. And so far today, He's got one, but was denied as he tried to get the second one.
It's a loss of two. Now third down.
Sometimes with the running game, you just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter. No time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been
doing. This nigga dumb as shit. At the goal line. This nigga turned into
shit. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Anthony Barr. He's at the 50. He's at the 40. 20. 10. 5. And he's going to score. It's a Viking touchdown. So from one end zone all the way to the other. Talk about a turnaround.
And how about the excitement that that play generates for his team? Not just the points on the board, but the momentum and taking it from coast to coast, end zone to end zone. What a tremendous play. Now get that man an oxygen tank.
That's your boy Old Mo, you said momentum, right?
Old Mo, I think he's kind of limping across at the end because of that distance, but he made it.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll probably wish he'd reconsidered here. It will cost him 10 yards as he's down at the 15.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light there. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. On second down, Kamara. They find some open field here. There he goes, right side. The 40.
You better not get fucking hot.
20, 10, touchdown.
Pussy-ass nigga wanna fucking try me. Fuck what you heard, Gucci with the Robin jeans. I done made $1 million, now I'm ready for the three. Got to land up on the line, trying to hop up on the team.
Certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns.
I hit his up with that motherfucking jet shit.
What he's doing
is contributing
to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
Oh, what you heard, Gucci with the Robin jeans. I done made $1 million, now I'm ready for the three.
Got that'll be taken in the end zone. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. And now out comes Minnesota. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what
it should have been a fucking pick.
This is a really important drive, and we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
After that throw, and it was definitely one that he would love to have back, I wonder what's going through his head. I wonder what kind of mind game he's playing with himself to get himself back on track. Because a lot of guys, that's what they do. They have little triggers that when the mechanics are off, or if they make a bad throw, that they go to that place to get themselves back in sync.
Flushed out right.
Oh, my God.
There, 26 yards. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out
which
play
will
work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
First and goal. They'll look to smash it in. Maybe a quarterback sneak here. Bridgewater again. And he's gonna
score. Oh, that's a hit stick.
Touchdown.
That's some bullshit.
Teddy Bridgewater. His first touchdown on the
that
year.
Is some bullshit.
And the Vikings are able to close the gap just a bit.
That's all bullshit. That is a fucking hit. Get the fuck out of here, bro. Man, this is suck my dick, bro.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
Fuck out my dick for that shit.
This is fielded a couple yards deep.
Dude, that camera ain't over here. Fuck up this shit. This is bullshit.
Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And the points, they have come fast and furious in this quarter.
You really don't want to be on the defensive side of the ball right now, do you? Because you're either thinking,
the ball!
I just need to get out of the game for a while because I just can't slow these guys down.
Oh my god, this motherfucker think he's fucking good or some shit.
One guy makes a big play and that can help change things.
They'll be looking for disruption on both sides right now. To throw, it's Carr.
Oh, I thought that one was kicked
by me. It brings up third.
That was hard flash. I'm gonna got his bitch ass.
Now the secondary's really struggled today, but that's a bullshit. Bit of a measure of revenge, isn't it? And they just followed the basic rules. C ball, knock ball away. Turned into a nice play.
On third down, here's Kamara. Kamara's got the first down and then some. He's at the 50. He's at the 40. Past the 20. 10.
Pussy.
Play there.
A hey, that motherfucking is that damn jet sweep? That's the way he can't stop that shit.
And that'll make this a three-score game as the lead moves stop. To 17.
He can't stop that fucking jet sweep.
Blunt's now to kick this.
I should run this shit the whole fucking game. These three guys like that bitch. Yeah, that damn jet sweep fake.
That's fielded in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. Now the Vikings offense works their way back onto the field. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
Pick the ball, Marshawn!
Collision there, jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's
one
that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Off the play fake, Bridgewater.
We all up. Everything all up. Everything all up.
Trying to improvise.
Oh, my God. Got broke the fuck off.
Big pickup that time on what's gonna wind up.
Dude got broke the fuck off. That nigga broke the shit out your ass. How the fuck that work?
They go play action here on first down.
You can suck my dick in the ass
and
go
no
again.
Options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down.
That's
right?
A pick.
He rifles one that's intercepted.
That's a pick. That's a pick.
Turn stops just a few yards shy of midfield. Spot the ball at the 47-yard line.
Hey, bitch.
Both defenses have had their struggles, but they've been good enough to get to this lead and another nice play there to help preserve the lead.
I'm running. It's been only like running before this damn lead. This nigga, he deserved this damn treatment.
But this time, the big swing was taken, and it didn't land. Nice play by them on defense.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
7 yards to pick up on the pitch and catch. Well, a clear running situation. Try to take time off the clock. He ran the previous play, set that play action up nicely.
Boy, did they ever, because they'd shown the ability to run the football So now you lose your keys as a defense. You dive for the running play, and they hit him over the top.
Now Kamara, and he is going to lose yardage here. It goes as a loss of six, and now third down.
Brent, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there, and now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring seven, eight, nine, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26.
That nigga used to hit my head there with him. That nigga used to hit me good.
And now he'll tuck it and run. Only a yard on the keeper, and it'll be second down. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. Six, seven, eight, nine.
And he's going to go down here.
You know, speaking on my name, I'm going to get a clip. And they show that ass in my brain, but I'm still here.
Defensively, pressure coming off that right side from the DM.
And that's the blind side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's the side you don't see quite as well. And that's why you rely on your left tackle, maybe your highest-paid offensive lineman, to take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
And that is incomplete.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion. And both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering when it's going to go good or bad for your team.
So it's three more points, and that widens things out even further here in the fourth.
Hey, in this league, you can never have too much. So if you're in range, grab the three whenever you can.
This is taken about six. Now a hit and a loose football. And this is picked up by the Saints. And he'll score. Touchdown, New Orleans. A big play there. His first touchdown on the year.
You gotta be kidding.
And the Saints add on to their lead. So they get the one score, kickoff, get a fumble, take it right back to the house. Two touchdowns within a matter of about 10 seconds on the game clock.
It's like a big 1-2 punch that may lead to a knockout.
So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. Gets fielded in the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. And out now come the Vikings. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. They'll roll him out right. Flush to his right. Now he's going to go deep down the left side. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And he gets all the way down. 30-yard line.
Right,
the young connection
hook out there. Bridgewater
Diggs.
Now fuck this nigga up.
45 yards. Now a play fake here on first down. Escaping the pressure right. Escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Trey Hendrickson in there to get him for sack number 9 now on the year. So the D gets the sack on first, and now it brings up second down. On play action, it's Bridgewater. And it's caught inside the 5. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. And there they got him the ball. Just get it to him, let him do the rest.
He probably said that to his quarterback as he broke the huddle. I like the play call. Just get it to me. I'll take the rest. Run after catch, and he loves that, and he's going to carry that in at contract time.
Yeah.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. about a yard deep. And the decision to come out is going to cost him five as he's taken down right at the 20. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted.
That's a long field goal
that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that, and they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
This should work out perfectly for me, bro.
Throw on second down.
God damn. That damn left tackle getting that right for the shit.
Defensive end gets in there that time. They were in a 4-3. What's the responsibility of the ends versus the tackles there, Charles?
Well, most of the time when you talk about the ends, they're your pass rushers. They're the guys that you turn loose to try and get to the guy who's going to throw the football. The tackles, usually more of the run stuffing variety. But the way this game is advanced, you're wanting a little bit of everything out of all of your guys. But let's just go ahead and break it down and make it simple. The guy who's the right defensive end versus a right-handed quarterback, that's the blind side. He's going after the quarterback. He's going to put him on the ground.
Here's Jacob Shum now. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the fourth quarter. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And we have reached the 2-minute warning. And now out comes Minnesota. Last time they were out, they scored.
6-3.
Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
Just try Marshawn Lattimore.
This is
oh my God! Get the fuck out of here!
Time for a break.
This game's so fucking fake.
Finish this one off after this, and the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense
so
is in the
fake
red zone. Bridgewater now looking to throw on first. And his throw is incomplete. Dalvin Cook is running back, the intended target. And now it's second down.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
Hey, tell that nigga he signed Aaron Rodgers. Nigga signed Aaron Rodgers, they ain't using. Ain't no game excuse.
Second down throw for Bridgewater. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And he's going to be brought down.
I told you he comes for everybody in the damn squad.
6 yards.
I told y'all that.
And that'll lead to a third down.
Quick to let him nigga have it.
To the air again with Bridgewater. Eluding the pressure right.
Fourth.
And it's caught. In the end zone, touchdown, Minnesota.
Shit. 1 minute and
a great effort.
I could shoot clock for 125.
Touchdown on the year. And the Vikings are able to cut into that deficit. And that will cut this lead down to 13.
I was cool enough blocking down here in the list, though. He's not my type. Why the fuck?
Bro.
Trey said that's not his type of quarterback.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
flexing on these niggas, about to spill a blue honey. Homie, I listen to that song while I was smoking. That shit is fun. Fuck.
Well, a design run for their wideout. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
So look at the players that got in his head. Look at that player that got in his head.
Fresh shut of downs.
First play of the drive, a first down run. That sets you up for whichever way you want to go. Do you come right back and run the football again because you've got them on their heels? Or do you play chess match with them? Break tendency and go play action and go for the big shot.
I'm going on the bucket now in the lead though.
Carr gonna look to throw. Dancing to his left. And he is out of bounds just a yard or two shy of the 30. A big game there, and that should certainly be enough to put this one in the win column. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Toss play, Kamara. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Yard line. 9 good yards here on the run, and now third down.
But you got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third and manageable with that run.
Drops this off to Kamara out of the backfield. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line. It's a gain of 6, and that ought to just about do it.
Oh, man.
And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. To the 15, right at the 15-yard line. And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left. Oh, now look at this. They're lining up to add 3 more, a little insult to injury here late in the game. And his kick here is good. And that will swell the lead to 16. So yet another field goal to end the drive. That has been a very common theme. He's now hit 5 of them in this game.
Yeah, Brandon, as an offense, you hate that you've had to call on your kicker so often, but you have to love the fact that time and time again, he's come through.
And this one travels out of bounds. So unsuccessful there on the onside kick try.
Here we go with this shit. Nope, bitch. Here we go with this shit. Everybody wanna goddamn attack my ass.
Incomplete. As time has run out on this football game. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying,
but
hey,
the Hawks love it.
Up every week, we'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for New Orleans, they keep pace for a playoff spot as they move to 7-3.
Say his nickname of Murray.
Head back home next week to take on the Baltimore Ravens. Meanwhile, for the Vikings, it was a game they really needed as they drop back to 4-6. And they'll be on the road next week as they get a date with the Seahawks in Seattle. So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. From Minneapolis, so long, everybody.